Your scientists, many of them, now understand that the so-called Big Bang is not necessarily the beginning of everything, it's just the beginning of your particular universe, yes?
Right.
But infinity is infinity. And there are many Big Bangs, as you say, many cycles that occur within infinity. Many universes, what your scientists have come to understand as the multiverse. So really, there are many Big Bangs. But in terms of your particular universe and its so-called beginning, the idea is, again, as an analogy, as an illustration, imagine, if you will, that there is only one particle and nothing else. All right? If you wish to represent this as simply a tiny subatomic particle floating in a big, empty, infinite black void, that's all right. It will do for the purposes of the illustration, even if that's not necessarily literally true.
Right.
So, now imagine that because there is only this one subatomic particle, it has absolutely nothing else to relate to, yes?
Right.
So there really is no gravity, there really is no sense of mass, there's really no sense of space or time. It just exists as a point of pure existence.
Right.
Thus then, it is capable of doing anything and everything imaginable. In other words, it can travel at infinite speed. Nothing holds it back. There are no laws of physics yet. You follow me?
Yes.
Thus, if you understand that that single particle can travel throughout that void, that big infinite void, at infinite speed, then that means that particle can actually appear to be everywhere at once, yes?
Right.
Thus, it can actually appear to be an infinite number of particles, even though it's actually only one particle.
That makes sense.
That's the Big Bang.